Always drink your water, kids. Anyways, welcome back to the vlog. My name is Philip Latocha, and today we're going to be talking about the Nike Pegasus Turbo 2 after 150 plus miles. But before we get into it, make sure you like the video, subscribe to the YouTube channel. Lots of cool stuff coming up. Looks like we're building some momentum on the channel as well. Lots of viewership, a lot of subscribers coming in. And of course, thank you very much. If you are already subscribed and you already watched the content, it means a lot to me. Hopefully you are learning stuff from this content, and hopefully you guys can teach me stuff as well as we go along in this fun running adventure. Anyways, without further ado, let's run the montage. Shot is up, but the world's still buzzing. It's getting hot, but the wells keep bleeding. Chemicals so they can't stop talking. Okay, we're back. So anyways, Nike Pegasus Turbo 2 after 150 plus miles. So where do we start? Well, first and foremost, I've mentioned this probably in the last two videos I had about the shoe. I'm late to the party. So the shoe came out in like middle to late 2019, and basically it's been available even in 2020 to buy through, you know, different vendors like StockX, and sometimes on the Nike website you can get a different color scheme as well. First off, let's just go over general specs for everyone that's new to the video and hasn't seen it yet. Nike Pegasus Turbo 2. The stack height from heel to toe is about 10 millimeters. Some people suspect it's 8 millimeters, but I'm pretty sure it's 10. We have ZoomX foam right across the shoe. Of course, that's a good thing. There's no carbon plates or anything like that. It's a soft, easy ride on the shoe. It weighs about 220-225 grams on average. This is a size 8.5, and I believe that puts it at about 7.2 to 7.3 ounces, give or take. It might be a little bit less than that. But relatively speaking to most Nike shoes on the market, this is a pretty light shoe. And that being said, we'll talk about it more later, how it affects the ride. Of course, we got this translucent mesh upper on the shoe, which is very comfortable, very flexible, very breathable. I don't have any issues with it as of right now. We have the shoe collar, which is a lot stiffer and a lot less cushion than its predecessor, which was the Nike Pegasus Turbo. Of course, slightly different design between the two collars as well. There's a lot more cushion on this one, less cushion here, but this one, I think, in my opinion, is a lot more stable than this particular collar. And then, of course, the tongue of the shoe is more stable to like what Nike and like other brands have been using a little bit more often. It's got like the slight offset tilt to the outside of the shoe versus the original Pegasus Turbo, which just has this standard tongue just right across. And again, it's got some cushion on it, and it's okay. It's a different ride than the Peg Turbo 2, of course. So I think that's all we need to discuss about this shoe. Yeah, I think so, on that front. Let's talk about it after 150 plus miles and its ride. So, first things first, let's look at the bottoms of the shoes and start explaining some of this. So, this is what we've got going on the bottoms. That's the shoe that I want to kind of focus on, is that right one. Left one doesn't have a whole lot of craziness going on, but, yeah, let's talk. So, normally, this is a strange wear and tear that I'm seeing here, and I think I know the answer why. And this is, like, rule number 2 with running shoes, is, like, you should never walk or like drive in the shoes that you're going to be running in until after their end of life and you turn them into like a casual shoe. I've broken this rule dozens of times with the Peg Turbo 2. You can tell by my right foot. You can see that the foot moves between like the brake and the gas pretty often. And now you see that there's wear in the middle here where my foot would be pushing like on those pedals. That could be one explanation for what's going on. It is probably the best explanation, mostly because the wear on the outside that I'm paying attention to is still not as bad as I would expect it to be. But it is still a little bit noticeable. Probably, yeah, no, the outside's not even that bad. You see that it's got like the slight design on the rubber lip there. But yeah, it's not so bad on that piece there. So yeah, this is as a result of driving in this shoe, and yeah, don't do that, guys. Definitely not. Another real dumb thing that's happened to this shoe while I've been running in it is actually in two places. One, you can see this huge rip in the rubber that I've got right there, and you can see this rip right there as well. This is rule like number 5 or 6 when it comes to running, is when you take off your shoes, make sure you untie them and take them off by hand. Don't use like the tip of your other shoe to push down to yank the shoe off. Like, that's been a bad habit I've developed with a lot of shoes, and it's showing with this Peg Turbo that like this shoe definitely it's not meant to be pulled off like that in any sort of way. And it's gotten to the point where I've ripped the two ZoomX foam plates off, and then now it's kind of ripping off this heel. Kind of a lot. Hopefully it survives though, but yeah. Note to self, don't do that. It's not good for the life of the shoe. It's probably not good for the performance. Luckily I'm not a heel striker, so I don't imagine this is gonna impact my running too much, unless it starts ripping to a point where like, I don't know, the weight of the shoe is different than this one. I don't know if that would be like a major effect, but yeah, don't do that. In my personal experience with this shoe, I bought it mostly as like a tempo runner originally, but since then it has shifted to be more of my everyday trainer. That's because I've added a lot more shoes to my lineup that are more tempo worthy, more built for tempo runs, more for threshold workouts. And that's why this shoe has been not necessarily downgraded, but it's been specialized for my everyday running. When I got back from elevation, my first run in this shoe was about like 6 minute per mile pace. Of course, just riding along, having some fun with it. And since then, my paces have dropped pretty drastically in this shoe to about like 7 minute mile, maybe 6:50 max. And then like my lows would be like 7:30s. But there's a lot of other factors involved with that, such as like post-marathon fitness drop and like trying to pick it right back up. Also, me experimenting with Maffetone, which we'll talk about in another video. And yeah, there's just some other things kind of in play that are resulting in the shoe being a lot slower, but at the same time being a lot more consistent in my training and still reliable in that sense. Of course, because I can still use this on every, like most of my everyday runs, and I just don't have an issue with it. Like, I know what I'm going to expect when I run in this shoe, especially nowadays. So, overall, my impressions of the shoe after 150 plus miles is, if you take care of the shoe, it'll take care of you. Don't be an idiot like me with this particular pair and like, you know, rip it up, drive in it. Walking it very often. Just take care of the shoe, please. And that goes for all of your running shoes. The longer you take care of them, the more, you know, you'll get out of them. But don't forget, on the other side of that pendulum is that your shoe is also a tool. You shouldn't just be like praising it and leaving it on like some shelf for 5 years because it looks nice. You should be able to use it. Unless you've got like a pair of like, I don't know, Jordans or something. I'm sure people take care of those differently. So again, in my personal case, the only thing I'm really watching out for is just to see how my right shoe plays out, both with the foam and the rubber at the bottom of the shoe, and how this foam on the back is going to be handling the next 300 plus miles in my training regimen. So again, overall, I would definitely recommend this shoe to you as an everyday trainer, a shoe that you can use on your slightly faster workouts, unless you have a slightly faster shoe available to you, but this will still get the job done. Of course, make sure you take care of the shoes also, so you don't rip them up in these weird places, and you know, driving in them, don't mess this up either. It'll mess up the life. But yeah, overall, I would definitely still recommend this shoe to just about any runner who's willing to give them a shot. So anyways, that's all I got for this video. Thanks for watching, and I will see you guys real soon.